In school, you might have been good in language or in science and not so great in math. But you were always told to focus and concentrate more on math because that's an area where you needed improvement. And college was no different either. And when you started working, you found companies focusing a lot of time and money on fixing the skill gap of employees. What if you had concentrated more on your favorite subjects? What if companies started focusing more on employee strengths rather than fixing their skill gaps? Let's see. Most of us spend so much time worrying about things we are not good at, be it at home or at work or at school, college. It's like seeing the small black dot and focusing all your energy on it while you fail to see the huge white canvas surrounding it. For instance, consider you are good in coding and you have a natural knack for it. On the other hand, communication is not your strong point. Instead of focusing on your strength, which is coding in this case, you end up spending a lot of time worrying about not being very good in communication. At one point, what you can't do takes over what you can do. In the process, you lose sight of your biggest strength. This is how most of us end up becoming an individual who is just about average in everything, instead of an individual who could have been best at something. Now coming back to school example. We probably spent so much time and energy focusing on areas that needed improvement instead of focusing on subjects that we were naturally good at. But no, we took extra classes, tuitions, and spent hours trying to drastically improve our scores in subjects that weren't our strengths. Things haven't changed much for some of us since then. We still are trying to fix the lack of something instead of focusing on our strengths. This is where we have to understand the concept of adequacy versus excellence. If you are brilliant in the technical aspects of your job, that's your area of excellence and that's where you should focus most of your time and energy on, because you are valued for your excellence in the technical skills. On the other hand, if communication is a problem area for you, just improve it to a level of adequacy. It's okay to be just adequate in some areas in life and be the best in areas that are your strengths. Talking about identifying your true limitations, I'd like to share a thoughtful story which I read a few years ago. In the circus, when an elephant is small, one of its legs is usually chained to a small pole in the dirt so that it doesn't run away. The baby elephant tries a couple of times to break out of the chain but fails. Even after the elephant grows into a huge animal, it still is chained to that small pole. The elephant rarely tries to break out of the chain because in its mind, it's a task that cannot be done. Imagine such a huge animal which is capable of uprooting trees, believing that it cannot break out of a small chain. Similarly, just because you couldn't do something at some point in your life doesn't mean you're bad at it or you can never do it. It's just a lack of practice and not a lack of skill set. For instance, if you had tried public speaking in school or college and it didn't work out, it doesn't mean that you still can't talk in front of people. All you need is a little bit of practice and it comes with time. So before you declare something or you accept something as your weakness, make sure that you've given it a reasonable number of tries. It is your limitation only if you had constantly struggled with it. So don't accept it as your weakness after trying it out only for once or twice. We are not talking about ignoring our limitations entirely, because no amount of strengths can equal a major weakness. The trick here is to find a right balance. And that's why we spoke about being adequate in certain areas of weaknesses. If you're excellent in coding, but your job also demands you to talk to various people, you have to strike a balance by developing your communication to a level of adequacy. Set measurable goals to improve your communication. Spend a little time every day. Remember, we are not striving for excellence here, but just adequacy. You are a valued resource for your strengths. That's why we have teams and organizations, to complement each other's strengths and limitations. So contribute more in your strongest areas. Delegate or seek help in the areas of your limitations. In short, play your strengths while you are completely aware of your limitations. Focus on your strengths until your weaknesses become irrelevant. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, give it a thumbs up and let me know in the comment section below. And please don't forget to subscribe to Mace Winner's channel. I post videos every Thursday. Until we meet next week, bye and be well.